everyone at 1995 here in the video game fanfiction plot with a new chapter for you all of Rock of Steel. I do hope you enjoy it, and remember, I do not own the Transformers Prime series or any music within this video, and I give full credit to its author Haley Moss on Wattpad. Chapter 11, Shadow Zone. Ella POV. I woke up to find I was in someone's bathroom. When I saw wrenches in most of the room, I knew it Ratchet's room. My head was a little tender from yesterday's events, but other than that I felt fine. I moved my legs over the bed and hopped down to the floor. "Ep hep hep, what do you think you are doing, Ella?" Ratchet asked. "Getting up, I have school soon, Ratchet," I told him. "How do you feel? How's your head?" Ratchet asked. "A little tender, but I'm fine. Can I use your shower in here?" I said, then asked. "Yes, you can," Ratchet said. I grabbed my bag that magically appeared near me when I know I left it in Magnus. I went into the human-size shower and took a shower. I got done and put on some jean shorts with a fitted pink shirt with my black socks. I scrunched my long blonde hair. I walked out of the bathroom and out of Ratchet's bathroom. I walked out into the hallway, into the main part of the base. I saw just Ratchet and Ultra Magnus standing there by the computer. "Hey guys, I'm ready to go to school now," I said, grabbing both of their attention. Magnus walked over to me, then transformed into his truck. I got into the passenger seat and closed the door. As we were driving to school, Magnus said, "How is your helm?" I smiled. "He doesn't use human anatomy. It's a little tender, but it's good, no headache," I told him. "I wanted to sleep in my bathroom with me, but when I went to take your Ratchet, his me in the helm with a wrench," Magnus said. I just busted up laughing, then said, "Oh man, I wish I was awake to see that." Magnus just hummed. "It's kind of like a reflex for us when someone else gets hurt, but not seriously hurt. We think it's funny and we automatically laugh. I'm sorry," I told him. "It's going to be a while until I fully understand human life," Magnus said. I just smiled as we pulled up to the school. "See you after school, Magnus," I said as I laid a quick kiss on his dashboard. "I hope I won't kissing something inappropriate. Until then, Ella," Magnus said. I hopped out and went to the school. School went by just like every day, boring, except in for RDH hour, which was my basketball hour. I loved that hour. I went to my locker and grabbed my English book and science book. Most of the time I usually only had homework every day that only came from two classes, because I finished the rest while in class. Migo is a different story. I've offered to help her with her homework, but she just says it's okay, I'll finish it later. In which I doubt she ever does, since she stays in detention all the time. Once I gathered my things, I went out the school doors that led outside. I saw Magnus on the other side of the street. I looked both ways before crossing the road, and then I got into the passenger seat. I put my bag in the floorboard of the passenger seat, while I moved over to the driver's seat. I buckled my seat belt and then I put the truck into drive. "Ella, what are you doing? You know I can drive," Magnus said. "Yes, but I haven't got to drive your truck form since the first time I met you. Min, please? B and Wheeljack let me drive theirs," I said. I made a pouted face. "Always works on my dad if I really want something. It must have worked, cause he me control the wheel." I placed my right foot on the gas and pulled away from the school. Once we were out on the highway, I checked for any cars. None. "Magnus, whatever you do, don't take control of the wheel." I told him the same thing I told B. "I want going to drift or do a donut, though." "Okay, Ella," Magnus said wearily. "Ha. I scare him. Yeah, right." I pressed the gas pedal all the way down to the floorboard. I put the metal to the pedal. "Ella, you're going too fast," Magnus said. "I know, that's the point. Haven't you noticed I'm a need for speed? I love the adrenaline." "Live a little, Magnus," I told him. We were almost to the base doors when I noticed B was a little ways behind us. "Can you go faster, Magnus? I know I've got the pedal all the way floor, but you're a hot kick-ass Cybertronian. Don't tell me you don't have any more speed hot stuff," I asked. "Accelerate," he said, and then he went even faster than we were even going. It felt like we were flying. We left B in the dust. The base doors opened and Magnus slowed down to where he came to a sudden halt. I was flung towards the steering wheel. But Magnus tightened the seatbelt around me so I wouldn't be harmed. I grabbed my bag and then I hopped out. I watched Magnus transform. It was amazing. I always felt like there is so much power cascading off of him when he transforms. So hot, actually. I don't know why I have such an attraction to him. Even in his Cybertronian body, I just can't get him out of my head and even out of my heart. I walked up the stairs where Maiko was drawing on the couch. Ella, that was the fastest I have ever gone when not in battle, and I must say I was scared at first for what you were going to do, but then I much rather enjoyed it, Magnus said. Then he went and stood where Ratchet and Optimus were discussing something. Dude, Ella, were you driving? Cause I've never seen Magnus drive like that unless it was in battle, B asked. Yeah, I was, and it was so awesome. I didn't do a donut or drift, but that was just as fun, I told him. He gave me a thumbs up and walked over to where the others stood. I was watching Maiko draw when Bulkhead said, "What does he want? Another army of the undead?" Maiko looked up from what she was drawing and said, "Zombie cons? Oh boy, I know that look. Maiko, that's a bad idea, but I won't let you go alone, okay?" I told her. I hated zombies. They were so gross looking, like I could throw up. Okay, awesome, I'll sit up here when they go through, and when they all go through, I'll make the break for it. You go and stand close by the ground and go after me, Maiko told me. I nodded and got up and went down the stairs and stood a little ways from the ground bridge. I pulled out my phone, acting like I was texting someone. The bots were talking. Looks like Optimus, Ratchet, Bulkhead, Magnus and B were going through, leaving RC with ground bridge duty. Go get him, Bulkhead, Bryn the Hurt, Maiko said. That's not like Maiko to not want to go, I heard Jack say to Raph. She's defiantly up to something, Raph said. When RC started the ground bridge, they went through and transformed as they did. When they were way into the green vortex, Maiko made a run for it, making a break, I heard Jack say. Maiko was into the vortex, then I accompanied her. We were almost through when Jack grabbed Maiko and I's arm. It's not safe, Jack said. That's why I'm going with her, to keep her out of trouble, I told him. You with her is double trouble, Jack said. I'm not going to miss my first zombie and throw down, Maiko said as he ripped mine and hers arms out of Jack's grasp. We both ran through the vortex that led into a canyon where the bots were. Then Jack and Raph ran through also. We all climbed up onto this ledge where the bots wouldn't notice us. Hopefully. That's not Megatron, Bulkhead said. Rise, Skyquack, rise. A strawny bot that kind of reminded me of a big Dorito said. His voice was kind of scream-like, I'll just call him Screamy. Let's see some fight of the living dead already, Maiko said. I just rolled my eyes, as we all got down on our hands and knees. Maiko, what were you thinking? Jack asked. She's wand, Raph said. Hey, Ella went through too, Maiko routed me out. Oh well. Yeah, well, she won't thinking either, she can't protect you, Jack said. I just turned towards the bots and watched. Hey, I totally missed out last time, did could be my only chance to take some snaps, Maiko said. Then reached to where her phone was, but realized she didn't have it and was freaking out. My cell phone, I must have dropped it back at base, Maiko said. I can't believe you made me lose my phone, Maiko screamed at Jack. Maiko, shush, I told her, with my finger over my mouth. How is this my fault? Jack asked. Then I heard, oh no, then base to Optimus, the kids are missing, RC said. We have a visual, Optimus said. Send the ground bridge immediately, Optimus said. I saw two ground bridges open up. Two? I heard Ratchet say. You three into our ground bridge, now, Ratchet yelled. Commande, Jack said as he pulled Maiko along. I ran after them and into the green vortex. _ Ultra Magnus POV. Oh Ella, why didn't you stay put? I watched the humans and Della all go through to which I hope was our ground bridge. If they landed on the Khan's warship, they would never survive. Ratchet, what is happening? Optimus asked. The ground bridge portal must be feeding back on each other. Ratchet said. Ella. I said and Bulkhead said Miko. We got to get the kids out of there. Both Bulkhead and I moved towards our portal only to be knocked back with a huge energy blast. Bulkhead got up at the same time I did and asked what just happened? I can't be certain. Ratchet said. But if the two ground bridges sent to the same coordinates, the feedback could have caused a system overload. Ratchet also said. The kids made it through, right? Bulkhead asked. I was hoping for the same thing. RC, did the children make it safely back to base? Optimus asked. Negative, you don't see them? RC asked. No sign. Ratchet said. Ratchet, could the children be transported onto the Nemesis instead? Optimus asked. Not likely, if Starscream didn't end up at our base. The most likely explanation is the children arrived at a different location. They may have simply been transported to an unintended destination. Ratchet said. I really hope that they're okay, Epshley. Ella. Ella POV. We're probably in a different dimension. A Shoda zone. Raph said. Nerd alert. Miko said. I elbowed her in the ribs. Not enough to harm her, but enough to get a point across. All of a sudden we saw a huge zombie-like robot come around the corner and head towards the bot. Zombie. Miko yelled. Guys, look out. Jack yelled. We started running towards the bots. It's right behind you. Raph said. Magnus, turn around. I also yelled. Awesome, it can't touch them either. Miko said. Then the zombie turned towards us like he could see us. If that thing can't touch the bots. Jack said. Like we can't. Miko said. Then we're trapped in a shadow zone with a Decepticon zombie? Raph asked. If we aren't ghosts now, we will be soon. Miko said. I was starting to step away from the others and then I said, okay, I don't know about you guys, but I'm gonna take my leave and hightail it out of here. I said as I started running. We all started running then, and I hid behind a huge rock and pulled the others beside me when they ran by. Raph fell and Jack went back for him. My glasses, Raph exclaimed. Way too dangerous. Jack said. I can't see without them. Raph said. What are you 90? Miko said. I slapped her on the back of the head this time. Not helping. Jack said. Fine. Miko said after rubbing the back of her head. She ran out and got Raph's glasses, then handed them to him and said, here you go, Gramps. Miko, I facepalmed myself. Then we started running again as the zombiekin was still after us. Maybe we could trap it, try and crush it. Miko suggested. With what? Nothing here is solid except us and the ground. Raph said. We can't run forever, but maybe we can hide? Miko asked. Good luck finding a place to hide in the big hole in the ground. I for one could run forever if it kept me alive. I said. Okay, miss, I own the cross-country road. Miko said. The best thing about zombies is they're so slow. Miko said, and as we stopped to take a breather. We didn't see the zombie anymore. Then Simone's ringtone went off. Is that your? Miko asked. Raph finished with phone? Jack grabbed his phone from his pocket and tried to answer it. Hello? RC? But all we heard was static. Jack hung up after not getting anything. Guys, the phone rang, we're getting a signal. Jack said. Maybe we can't try reaching them a different way. Texting. Raph said. Text me if my phone is back at base, maybe they will see it. Miko said. Can you type and run? Raph asked. Then we saw the zombiekin again. I've never tried. Jack said. Jack, hand me your phone, I do it all the time. I said. He handed me his phone. I started typing the message, I was done before you can say count the money. I handed Jack back his phone. Wow, that was fast and you didn't even have to look. Jack said. Yeah, I'll explain later when we're not running for our lives. I told him. He nodded and we ran underneath the zombie's legs. While we were running, Miko decides to let out a snarky comment. Hello, Diju. What? Jack asked. Does this not look familiar to you? Miko asked. Not really. Jack said. Dude, we just ran one big circle. Miko said as we all looked behind us. Then we crashed into something. Whoa. We all sat as we sat up and then saw a robotic arm. Saw it? Michael said. It must have gotten trapped in here like us. Raf said. Well, if it's solid we can use it. Jack said. We all surrounded the arm to point it to where it would fire at the zombie. Does anyone know how to fire this thing? I don't see a trigger. Michael said. Starscream did something with his fingers. Raf said. What his name is Starscream. I've been calling him Screamy, that's the one that attacked Magnus and I the other day. I said. Dude, and you didn't tell me? Michael said. I forgot. I told her. I did forget to tell them. I don't even know if Magnus told them or not. We have one shot, we need to make it count. Jack said. Jack pulled one of the fingers. Ahahaha. And a rocket went off and blasted the zombie, hopefully killing him. How do you like us now? Michael said. But the only thing that the blast hit was the zombie's arm. Crud. Then the arm that was shot off came crawling after us. We started running again. How can a zombie arm move faster than an actual zombie? Michael asked. _ Ultra Magnus POV. We were all standing around the base wondering where they could have gone when a beep noise was heard. Michael's phone it wasn't blinking before. Bulkhead said. He pressed down on Michael's phone then said it's a message. In alternate dimension with zombie help. Bulkhead read off the message to us. That doesn't sound possible. RC said. Optimus asked Ratchet something but I wasn't listening until Ratchet said let's find out. Again I wasn't listening until Ratchet said who knows where the humans will end up. LPOV. We ran until we came upon Starscream's arm again. This place is like one big merry-go-round. Michael said. Then we heard Starscream say Skyquake cries your master summons as you. How did that freak get into our dimension? Michael said. He can't see us. Jack said forget Starscream we got to run some more. Michael said. We ran towards Starscream but then a ground bridge opened up. A ground bridge portal. Raf asked. That has to be our way out of here. Jack said. The Autobots saw our text. Michael said. If we go through we run smack into Starscream, if we down Raf said not finishing, but Jack did with we're zombie chow. Option 3 we keep running in circles. Michael said. I say we just run through and then try and outrun Starscream. I said. Follow my lead. Jack said as we got right up next to the portal. Michael was looking back at the crawling arm and saying oh, ooh, ooh, then Jack said now. We jumped through the portal and there was Starscream's legs. We ran past them when another portal opened up and the bots came through. Jack, Michael, Raf, Ella. Optimus said. We all looked up at him with the look. Then we all walked through the ground bridge and back to base. Okay, if you're going to blame anybody, blame me, and also Ella only went so that she could keep me out of danger. Michael said. I'm sorry, but can you say that again? Jack asked. This time I elbowed him in the ribs. Ouch, he said. I just looked at him. Michael, what you have endured has been less than a naught. We are just glad that you are all safe. Optimus said. Aw, he is so sweet and kind. Total best friend material. I guess it was a good thing you dropped this, too bad you didn't get any pictures though. Bulkhead said as he handed Michael her phone. I think I have zombie up close printed on my brain. Michael said. Man, Michael, mom and dad want us on time for dinner. I told her. Oh man. Michael said. There's always tomorrow. I told her. Bulkhead and Magnus transformed into their vehicles. I got into the passenger seat and closed the door. The seatbelt automatic buckled around me. Magnus' holoform appeared in the driver's seat. I looked over at him and his face was focused. I think I may be in trouble. Ellie, if I have to I will order you to stay at base or you will be confined to your house for a while and I will tell your father of today. You could have been seriously hurt. I don't want you following after us again even if it was to make sure Michael stayed out of trouble, am I understood? He said. Wow, I want accepting it to be not harsh. Yes I do, does this mean that you don't want to be my boyfriend because I'm sometimes reckless like Wheeljack? I asked. I wanted him to be my boyfriend, and if he rejected me I would be hurt, but I would have to get over it. You are, but I believe that is why I'm so attracted to you, and you're not afraid of what others think of you, and you stand up for others. Magnus said. So should I tell Wheeljack that you want to be his boyfriend? I asked sarcastically. No, I want to be your boyfriend, Ella, and not anyone else's, especially Wheeljack's, Magnus said. After he said that, I saw that we were home. I saw Michael already walking through the front door. I then leaned over and kissed Magnus on the cheek. He then grabbed my face gently and kissed me on the lips. I kissed him back and I pulled his bottom lip through to my mouth and sucked on it. Then he mimicked me. Then I grazed my tongue over his bottom lip, asking for entrance. I knew he didn't know what I was doing, but he followed my lead and did what did, and before long we were having a heated makeout session. I don't know how long we stayed like that, but I pulled away so that way I wouldn't be late for dinner. Wow, that was the most wonderful thing I have ever experienced in my many years of life. Magnus said. Same here. I said. I don't want to go, but I have to go eat dinner. Good night, Magnus, I told him. I got out and patted his head, then went inside the house and ate dinner. 1. After dinner I walked up to my room and just lay down in bed thinking about Magnus and I's first kiss, my actual first kiss too. I soon got up and changed clothes and then laid back down in a bed. Falling asleep shortly afterwards thinking about Magnus. I am going to stop right there. I do hope you enjoy this video. If you like to see more of me playing this game, hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and leave a comment down below. Until next time.